Admit it, when Oral Roberts beat The Ohio State, your bracket was done, right? Well, the good thing is nobody is perfect, literally. But even though there was no perfect bracket winner, we've got you covered with a second chance with the Sweet 16. Stay tuned to the end of the video to find out how you can still win $5,000. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Sports Geek. I'm your host, Jackie Ray, and this is why they call it March Madness, right? The last time a number 2 seed was bested by a number 15 seed was in 2016 when Middle Tennessee defeated Michigan State. I didn't even give Oral Roberts much of a thought. And the crazy thing is, there was never a time during the game where Ohio pulled far enough ahead to count out the Golden Eagles. 3 points was all it took to cause the first really big upset of March Madness. And I am certain most of us were out of contention for the perfect bracket right after that. To me, it was a fluke. Oral Roberts was not supposed to beat The Ohio State, but they definitely proved they were focused by beating the Florida Gators, who held the number 7 spot. And guess what? Once again, it was by 3 points. The Golden Eagles become just the second 15th-seeded team to advance to the Sweet 16 since 2013. The first round brought another big upset because no one I know thought Abilene Christian, who was the number 14 seed, would beat the number 3-seeded Longhorns. Such a close game, but Abilene Christian pulled it out by 1 point. UCLA, though, reset the timeline on Monday by beating Abilene by 20 points, but still, you have to give Abilene credit in all they have built from basically scratch and building the coaching staff and that team for the last 4 years to even be in the tournament. So, congratulations to you guys over at Abilene Christian. The second round didn't bring much in the way of upsets. Iowa, UCLA, and Gonzaga all won. The LSU-Michigan game was a nail-biter for just a second, but the Wolverines ended up beating the Tigers by 8 points. These kids really went out there and put in the work, so a big congratulations to all the teams who made it to the Sweet 16, and to some of you. Even though we didn't have anyone with a perfect bracket, let's take a look at our top 10. Jim the Ninja had the number 1 spot with 46 points. 6 of you came in second with 45 points, and 4 of you came in third with 44 points. I didn't want to slaughter your screen names, but congratulations on being in the top 10, and keep in mind, with the potential scores ranging from 100 points to 170, this is still anyone's game. So, shouts out to you guys once again for making the top 10, and even though you didn't have the perfect bracket, you are still receiving this honorable mention. So, well done. And all of you who entered to win our perfect bracket, you are still in the running. Don't forget, those of you with the most points throughout the tournament can still win. The entry with the most points will win $350, second $165, and third will win $75. But if you win the cash for the most points, you can't win the Sweet 16 prize. It would be nice, you guys, but you cannot win both. Now, here's an interesting fact. We took a look at all of the entries just to see if there was a consensus on who you thought would win it all. There is definitely a clear winner. From the West, 48% of you are going with Gonzaga, and it looks like we might have just one USC alumni who was confident in the USC Trojans. After Gonzaga, the confidence starts to fade. As we head to the East, 6.2% of you think Michigan will win. From the Midwest, Houston Cougars have 2.9% of the votes. Baylor is leading the votes from the South with 10.3%, and apparently, some of you are really believing in fairy tales. But just a few of you, just over 1%, picked Oral Roberts to beat The Ohio State. For those of you who did not enter the perfect bracket contest, that is actually fine. Click the link below to enter the Sweet 16 contest. And all you bracketeers out there who did enter, how about a clean slate and a fresh start at perfection? All of you, whether you've entered before or not, can enter the Sweet 16 competition. And now, the good thing is you've seen some highlights. So you can put on your thinking cap and decide. Will Oral Roberts stay on their Cinderella tour all the way to the end? Will Greg McDermott have his redemption story and lead Creighton to their first ever NCAA championship? A lot of unanswered questions as we head into the Sweet 16, but the most important thing is I'm saying all of you still have a chance. Oh, I almost forgot the most important part. Just like before, this contest is completely free, so you have nothing to lose. Instead, you have fantastic incentives channel your inner March Madness, because if you get this one right, you'll win $5,000 and a new iPad Pro. But don't overthink it, because you're on the clock here, people. Enter while you still can. Sign up for the Sweet 16 brackets has already begun, and you only have until 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on Saturday, March 27th to enter. By then, you'll want to sit down, watch Oregon State versus Loyola to see if you can cross off your first win and move one step closer to that $5,000 and a new iPad Pro. Perfection is the goal, but don't forget, you can still win by scoring the most points, even if your bracket falls a little short. Remember, each game you call correctly during the Sweet 16 will earn you 4 points, the Elite 8, 8 points, Final Four, 16, and the Championship, 32 points. We will tally up the score at the end, and the first place winner will earn $125, second place, $75, and third place will receive a solid $50 in winnings. And again, this is just for the Sweet 16 competition. If you entered our Perfect Bracket competition, you can still re-enter the Sweet 16, but you can only win one. So make sure you enter again to increase your chances of winning. Did I mention it's free to enter? And don't forget, check back to see if the Perfect Sweet 16 bracket was won and to get tips on all your sports betting needs. And enjoy the madness, my friends. Once again, I'm Jackie Ray. Thanks for watching The Sports Geek, and we'll see you next time.